Good morning, students. Welcome to our e-learning class. Students, today in this video, we are going to start a new unit with chapter number 4 from book 2, that is India, People and Economy. From India, People and Economy, unit 2. Chapter 4, and the chapter name is Human Settlements. So this topic, this chapter, today we will discuss in this video. Students, this chapter is very important from examination point of view. Definitely few questions will be asked, both objectives and either 3 marks or 6 marks. So please do watch this video carefully and listen to my lecture with lot of attention and concentration. Students, the chapter name is Human Settlements. Before that, you should know what is meant by a settlement. Generally, a settlement means not solving the problems. A settlement means a cluster of dwellings of any type. A cluster means what? A group. Group. Cluster of dwellings. Dwell means what? House. A cluster of dwellings of any type or size where human beings live. I repeat, human settlement, settlement generally. Settlement means a cluster of dwellings of any type and size where human beings live. That's called settlement. So in this chapter we will discuss about human settlements. I mean, where the people are living, what type of houses they are living, whether they are living in rural areas or urban areas, whether their houses are in the form of clustered or semi-clustered or hamlet. We will also read about different types of towns, classification of towns, on what basis towns are classified, classification of towns on the basis of population. Okay, similarly so many things are there. So today we are going to cover the following topics. I mean, what is human settlement, definition of human settlement, difference between the rural and urban settlements, similarly types of rural settlements, their classification, each subheading I'll explain. So students, I'm starting the lesson. Listen carefully. What is human settlement? What is human settlement? Human settlement means a cluster of dwellings, I mean a group of houses of any type houses or any size where people, or I can say human beings live, is called, human settlement. I mean, to live, what human beings are doing? They'll erect a house or any other structure like hut, etc. So to live, human beings, they erect houses or any type structures and command some area. Command means bring some area or territory. Territory or area, both are same, as their economic support base. Thus the process of settlement inherently involves grouping of people. Settlements means grouping of people and appropriationing of territory as their resource base. Settlements are of different type. They vary from size and types. Settlements vary in a shape and size or type. They range from hamlet. Your hamlet, I'll tell you what is meant hamlet. Hamlet is also a type of human settlement. So settlements vary in size and type. They range from hamlet to metropolitan cities. From hamlet to metropolitan cities, the types of settlements are there. With the size, their economic character and social structure of settlements changes, and so do its ecology and technology. Settlements could be small and sparsely spaced. Sometimes some settlements are very small and the populations are sparsely spaced. Sparsely means what? Very less. Sparsely means very less. So settlements could be small and sparsely spaced. The sparsely located small settlements are called villages. The sparsely located small settlements are called villages. I repeat, what is village? The sparsely located small settlements are called villages. Specializing in agriculture, village people, what they will do? They are specializing in what? Agriculture and other primary activities. Either agriculture or any other activities related to agriculture. Primary, I mean, here mining, fishing, okay, animal husbandry, etc. On the other hand, there are fewer, I mean very less, fewer but large settlements. Lesser number but larger settlements which are termed as urban settlements. Which are termed as what? Urban settlements. They are less in number but what? Larger in population. And their main occupation is other than agriculture. Here other than agriculture means what? Either they will do secondary activities or tertiary activities. Now we will go to find out the difference between rural settlement and urban settlement. So before going that one, once again I'll tell about what is meant by human settlement. Once again, a settlement or human settlement may be defined as a cluster of dwellings of any type or size where human beings live. They vary in size from hamlet to metropolitan cities. They may be small and large. They may be closed or spaced. Closed means at one place, spaced means different places. And they practice primary activities, secondary activities and tertiary activities. Is called what? Human settlement. Now coming to the difference between rural and urban settlements. What is the difference between, or what are the differences between rural and urban settlements? So for this question, it's a 3-mark question. You have to draw in the form of table. In a tabular form, you have to write this answer. Difference between rural and urban settlement. Now first I'll tell about rural settlements and its features. Rural settlements, these settlements are very small. Okay, their main occupation is what? Primary occupations such as agriculture, mining, fishing, animal husbandry, forestry, etc. They provide raw materials, they extract raw materials, they produce food. Primary settlement people, they produce food. Their incomes are very low. Since their incomes are low, naturally their standard of living also will be low. And the density of these settlements will be very less. The density will be low. At the same time, these settlements are spaced. I mean, they found at different places. I repeat once again, primary settlements, first feature, primary occupation, like agriculture, forestry, mining, animal husbandry, forestry, etc. They provide raw materials, I mean they extract raw materials. They produce food for others. They are earning low income, hence their standard of living is also very less. The density of the settlements are very less. And they are sparsely, or the settlements are spaced at different places. On the contrary, urban settlements mostly the people are engaged other than primary activities. Here other than primary activities means what? Secondary and tertiary activities. What these people will do? Whatever raw materials are produced by the primary, those raw materials these people are process. I mean the secondary sector, the urban settlement people, they process the raw materials. They process the raw materials that are produced by the primary sector. Second one, they provide services. They provide services and their incomes are very high. When their incomes are very high, naturally their standard living will be very high. Similarly, they are highly density or highly densely populated. Urban settlements are highly densely populated and they are clustered. They are not spaced, they are clustered. One more difference, the literacy rate in rural settlements will be less whereas the literacy rate in urban settlements will be high. Now we will go to another topic, types of rural settlements. What are the types of rural settlements? Clear? This is the main topic, types of rural settlements. Rural settlements are classified into four types. Rural settlements are classified into four types. First one, clustered settlements, semi-clustered settlements, hamlet and dispersed settlements. So clustered, semi-clustered, hamlet and dispersed, these are the four types of rural settlements. These are the four types of rural settlements. Now I'll tell the features of rural settlements. What are the features of rural settlements? Example of rural settlements. Clustered settlements. Example of clustered settlements. Everything I'll tell. So listen carefully, students. Clustered settlements are generally, they are compact and closely built houses. Clustered settlements are very compact and their houses are closely built. Their living area is different from surrounding farms. In clustered settlements, their living area will be different from their farms. Now these clustered settlements, they are having recognizable pattern. A particular pattern they will have. A systematic pattern they have. Recognizable pattern. These patterns are different shapes, such as geometric, rectangular, radial and linear. What are their patterns? Rectangular, linear, radial. Sometimes defense may cause shape of the settlements. Defense, D-E-F-E-N-S-E. Sometimes defense may cause shape of the settlements. Availability of water also decides the shape. So availability of water is one of the factors that decides the shape of the settlement. So these are some of the features of clustered settlements. Now, clustered settlements, example where they are found. They are found in fertile alluvial plains. Ganga plains. Fertile alluvial plains, generally they are found in first they are found in fertile alluvial plains and also in the northeastern states. So clustered settlements are found in northern plains and northeastern states. Sometimes people even compact village for security or defense reasons, such as the Bundelkhand region of India, Bundelkhand region of central India and in Nagaland. In Rajasthan, scarcity of water has necessitated compact settlement for maximum utilization of available water resources. So examples, northern plains, northeastern states, Nagaland, Rajasthan, Bundelkhand uplands of central India. So in all these places we have the examples of clustered settlements. Now we're moving to semi-clustered settlements. Semi-clustered settlements, semi-clustered or fragmented. Semi-clustered settlements are also called fragmented settlements, and they generally results from tendency of clustering in a restricted area of dispersed settlement. I repeat, clustered settlements are also called fragmented settlements, and they are formed as a result from tendency of clustering in a restricted area of dispersed settlement. More often, such a pattern may also result from segregation or fragmentation of a large compact village. Now features. Again, as I told, formed due to the result from tendency of clustered in a restricted area of dispersed settlement. Second feature, segregation means division, separating. Segregation of large settlements may also the reason for this formation of these settlements. Some people may be forced to live separately from the main village. Some people are forced to live separately from the main village. Dominance group live in the center of the village. In a semi-cluster settlement, the dominant group of the village will live in the center of the village. People of lower strata live in the outskirts of the village. The people who are very poor, they live in the outskirts of the village. So these are the features of semi-clustered. And example I'm telling, examples are Gujarat plains. In Gujarat plains, such settlements are there, and also in some parts of Rajasthan. Now coming to what is meant by hamlet settlement. Hamlet. Sometimes settlements is fragmented into several units. Sometimes settlements are fragmented into several units, physically separated from each other, bearing a common name. I repeat, sometimes settlements is fragmented, divided into several units, physically separated from each other, bearing a common name. Hamlets are locally known as Panna, P-A-N-N-A, Panna, Para, P-A-R-A, Para, Palli, P-A-L-L-I, Palli, Nagla, N-A-G-L-A, Nagla, Dhani, D-H-A-N-A, Dhani. So these are the various names of hamlet settlements. Locally, they are named with different names. In various parts of the country, these type of things are found. This segregation or this, segmentation and ethnic factors, segmentation of a large village is often motivated by social and ethnic factors. Such villages are more frequently found in the middle and lower Ganga plains. This settlements are there. Chhattisgarh also it is there. In Chhattisgarh also hamlets are there, and lower valleys of the Himalayas. So lower valleys of the Himalayas, Chhattisgarh, middle and lower Ganga plains, these are the places where hamlet settlements are there. I read the features once again. Physically separated, these hamlet settlements are physically separated and located in different place, living with common name. They are locally called Panna, Pali, Dhani, Nagla, Para, etc. They are motivated by social and ethnic groups. And they are found in, I told you, middle and lower Ganga plains, Chhattisgarh and lower valley of Himalayas. Now moving to next one, dispersed settlements. What are dispersed settlements? So students, listen carefully. Dispersed, the name itself indicates what? Spread. That distant places. Dispersed settlements, they spread in different areas. Okay. Dispersed, or I can say isolated. Just like I told you, semi-clustered also called what? Fragmented. Like that, dispersed also called what? Isolated. So dispersed settlements are also called isolated settlements. Patterns in India appears in the form of isolated huts or hamlets, a few huts in remote jungles, where man cannot live, or in a small hills with farms or pasture on the slopes. Okay, extreme dispersion of settlements is often caused by extremely fragmented nature of the terrain and land resource based on habitable areas. Many areas of Meghalaya, listen students, Meghalaya, Uttaranchal, Himachal Pradesh, Kerala are having this type of what? Dispersed settlements. I repeat once again, dispersed settlements are also called isolated settlements. Okay, they are isolated in the form of huts and hamlets, located on hills or agricultural lands or in remote forest areas. Due to its nature of terrain and land resource and water, they are found. These settlements are generally found in Meghalaya, Himachal Pradesh, Uttaranchal and Kerala. Now students, we are moving to another topic, that is urban settlements. What are urban settlements? Unlike rural settlements, urban settlements are generally compact. They are very close. they are very close, compact and larger in size. Rural settlements are not compact, they are spaced. Okay, where urban settlements are compact and large in size. They are small in size, these are large in size. They are engaged in variety of non-agricultural activities such as secondary and tertiary activities. Okay, for their economic and social well-being. So, they engage in variety of non-agricultural, economic and administrative functions. As mentioned earlier, we have studied in the difference between rural and urban settlements. Okay, now, as mentioned earlier, cities are functionally linked to rural settlement areas around them. Thus, exchange of goods and services is performed sometimes directly and sometimes through a series of market towns and cities. Thus, cities are connected directly as well as indirectly with the villages and also with each other. You can see the definition of towns in the we will read in the definition of towns in the chapter 10. Okay, that is fundamentals of human geography, we will read. But before that, I want to say once again, what are urban settlements? Bigger in size, they are compact in shape. Okay, the settlements, their economic activities are not secondary and tertiary, other than primary. Okay, they are compact and large in size. Their occupation is non-agriculture and administrative activities. Their main work is what? Exchange of goods and services. And directly linked with rural settlements. These cities are always linked with what? Rural settlements. Or urban settlements are always linked with what? Rural settlements. Now, evolution of towns in India. Or I can say, evolution of cities in different periods. Evolution of cities or towns in different periods. Listen, students. According to this classification, we have divided cities or towns into three categories: ancient towns, medieval towns, and modern towns. I repeat, now we are going to read evolution of cities or towns in different periods, based on periods: ancient, medieval, and modern towns. Now, what are ancient towns? With example, what are ancient towns and their examples? So, ancient towns are those towns which are developed in some religious places. I mean, they developed as religious and cultural towns. So, we can say ancient towns are religious towns and also cultural towns. Towns in India having historical background, those towns which are located in India and having historical background over 2000 years old, those towns which are having historical background of 2000 years old, such towns are called ancient towns. I mean, 2000 years old history if they have, they are called historical towns. Example, Patna, I mean Pataliputra, Varanasi, Madurai are the examples. Varanasi, Patna and Madura. Varanasi, Patna and Mathura, these are the examples of what? Ancient towns. Now coming to medieval towns. What are medieval towns? Generally, these towns are the headquarters of kingdoms. Medieval towns are generally the headquarters of kingdoms. In medieval period of India, there are several kingdoms are there. So these towns are the headquarters of the kingdoms. There are more than 100 towns. More than 100 medieval towns are there in India. They are fort towns developed over ruined forts. In olden days or medieval period, there are forts were there. Fort, F-O-R-T-S, forts. So these medieval towns are built over the ruins of the forts. So they are called fort towns also. Example, Delhi, Hyderabad, Jaipur, Lucknow, Agra and Nagpur. I repeat, Delhi, Hyderabad, Jaipur, Lucknow, Agra and Nagpur. These are the examples of medieval towns. Now coming to modern towns, present towns. These towns are developed by British and other Europeans. Modern towns are developed by the Britishers or other Europeans. Generally, these towns are located very close to the sea coast. These towns are located very close to the sea coast. They were forts constructed by Europeans in these towns. Example, Surat, which is in Gujarat, Goa, Pondicherry, Mumbai, Madras, Calcutta. Goa, Pondicherry, Surat, Mumbai, Calcutta and Madras. These are the examples of modern towns developed by Europeans and the Britishers. They are usually located near the sea coast and they were forts constructed by Europeans. Now, next point, classification of towns on the basis of population size. Classification of towns based on the population size. Listen students, urban center with a population more than, urban center I mean town, urban center with more than population 1 lakh is called city or class 1 town. What are class 1 towns? What is a city? More than 1 lakh population. In any urban center, in any urban center, if the population is more than 1 lakh, either they are called city or class 1 town. Cities accommodating population size between 1 to 5 million. Now those cities where the population is 1 million to 5 million. Up to 1 million, class 1 towns or city. Between 1 million to 5 million, those urban centers are called what? Metropolitan cities. They are called metropolitan cities. Okay. Now, more than 5 million, suppose if the population is more than 5 million, then they are called mega cities. I mean, mega cities are bigger than metropolitan cities. Now, urban agglomerations, I mean urban towns. Urban agglomerations, number one, a town with its adjoining urban outgrowths. I repeat, urban agglomerations means what? A town with a town and its adjoining urban outgrowths. Two or more contiguous towns with or without their outgrowths. Third point, a city and one or more adjoining towns in their outgrowths together forming a contiguous spread. Now, last one, functions, or I can say functional classification of towns. Functional classification of towns. What are the functional classification of towns? Now, on the basis of functional classification of towns, towns are classified like this. Administrative towns. What are administrative towns? All capitals of states with the national capital. All capitals of the states with the national capital. The industrial towns. Example, Mumbai, Salem, Coimbatore, Modinagar, Jamshedpur. Industrial towns. Transport towns. What are transport towns? They may be ports. Okay, they may be ports primarily engaged in export and imports activities like Kerala, Cochin, I mean Vizag, Vizag or hubs of inland transport such as Agra, Dhulia, okay, Mughal Sarai, Itarsi, Katni, etc. Commercial towns, I mean business towns, commercial. Example, Satna and Kolkata. Now mining towns, Digboi, okay, Rani Ganj, Jharia, they are what? Mining towns. Here mining is taking place more. Now, garrison cantonment towns. This is very, very important. Garrison cantonment towns. What are garrison cantonment towns? I mean, where military has been kept, where military is stationed in that places, military soldiers are kept in those places, are called garrison towns. Example, Ambala, Mahu and Jalandhar. Ambala, Mahu and Jalandhar. Educational towns, where famous for what education, such as Pilani, okay, Aligarh, Varanasi, Pilani, okay, Varanasi and Aligarh. Now religious cultural towns, what are religious cultural towns, which is famous for what? Religion and culture, such as Varanasi, Tirupati and Amritsar. Now tourist towns, what are tourist towns? Like Shimla, Mussoorie, Nainital, Ooty, etc. So these are administrative towns, industrial towns, commercial towns, transport towns, mining towns, garrison towns, educational towns, religious towns and tourist towns. So these are the towns that are classified on the basis of what? Function. So students, apart from that one, nowadays smart cities mission is there. So that we will read later. So this is the end of this topic. We have covered all these topics today. So once again, go through the textbook, read in detail each and every sentence, every example, so that you can understand better. So we will come up with this this is the end of this video. We'll come with some more videos with the different topics from this book. Till then, take care. Thank you, students.